I'm here on the balmy shores of Lake Huron on the second floor of the work in progress of the Cooke family cottage. Derek, this is obviously a really compelling site in the summer, but a little tough to in the wintertime.
Yeah, it's definitely a little rough down here in February, but it's going to be a beautiful cottage in the summer and all the other seasons.
So this will be the great view that we're going to be experiencing from the bedroom out here. Right now, though, we're just at second floor construction, the ICF, getting a nice start on it. Obviously the weather's been a little challenging this winter so far, but let's go downstairs and have a look at some of the details of the ICF that you've been able to put together so far.
That would be great.
Gary, we were talking about one of the keys to ICF is just a little bit of planning, and one of the smaller areas that guys often forget is the mechanical penetrations.
Absolutely, Gord. It's so important with any type of construction. You want to make sure that you look over the plans and that you do make all of the penetrations beforehand. Unlike conventional construction, when you've got a concrete wall that you have to go through, it can be pretty expensive to have to come back. So like the carpenter says, you measure twice and you cut once and you make sure that you get all your penetrations where they need to be the first time.
It's not really a problem because you got to do it anyway. You just got to do it early rather than later.
100%. You have to do it. It's the same with any type of home. It's just that it's concrete instead of wood, so you really want to make sure you get it in the right spot.
Now, you'd mentioned earlier we were talking about the need for ventilation. Obviously, that's my background.
Exactly.
And you might be thinking, well, that's for the ventilation system, HRV, but this hole is actually for makeup air. That is, the building will be so tight, we're gonna have a rain shed in here, we actually need a little bit of makeup. It'll have a damper to it. I'll be pleased to show at the end of the final videos how this works. The actual ventilation intakes are actually up much higher, but we have all the penetrations in here for our solar, for our electrical, our plumbing, our ventilation, our water heater, all in this wall, all done. Mechanical guy was actually very pleased because he knows we've left room for him.
Exactly. Yeah, that's fantastic, Gord. This is great, exactly how it's supposed to be done. And it is very important that, as you can see, you've got some spray foam in here, that you seal it up properly so you're not gonna have any leaks or anything, and that the concrete's consolidated so that you're all good to go.
Gary, this was our first opportunity to kind of show the integration of good design, compelling design, with ICF. All architects in general love these windows that come into the corners to give that big natural look. The question we got with ICF was, can I do this with ICF?
Very good question, Gord, and the answer is, of course you can. What you're going to do with ICF is you are going to be putting some more reinforcement in the corner piece here, so that it is good and strong, that you're actually creating a concrete column here. But absolutely, you can do an ICF window right close to the outside. You do want to have that minimum concrete a column here, but it's absolutely not an issue whatsoever as far as doing it that way.
And then you were saying you were working with Derek with the block specifically on the increments. If you could just show that.
Yeah, so one of the things with ICF, as with any construction, is that when you're working with your architect and your engineers, is that if they know the sizes of the block and the height of the wall and things like that, it makes it a lot easier to fit everything in so that you're not making a lot of cuts. Now, the thing with ICF is no different than a traditional construction. When you've got 2x4s, you have to cut it to make it fit. So you, not a problem cutting. And in some cases here, we do have some standing seams, which we'll take a look at also. So as long as the webs all line up and you've got the architect with the dimensions of the block, it's going to make life a lot easier for you to put it all together.
I wanted to show as well this, when we go to put that wood buck in, people are going to be concerned about wood in contact with concrete. And obviously, two things: we don't want the wood itself to rot, nor do we want the wick to water. So one of the techniques is to use pressure-treated bucks. But in this case, I feel a better choice is actually a true capillary brick. And Derek, you're using the DuPont flashing system as part of that. So you just applied, describe what you did there.
Yeah, we pulled the release paper and stapled it to the back side of this so that wherever the concrete meets the wood, it was protected.
So in behind there, that's in that location.
So you won't be able to see any of it here.
Right. And we may show it next video, give it a little sense of what that's about. But that's a butyl-based, needs a little primer in the really cold weather, but that makes sure that there's no moisture movement from the concrete back through into the wood.
And that's an excellent way to put your bucks in, and window bucks are a very important part of the ICF construction. A lot of people say, well, how do I put my windows in? It's relatively simple, putting the membrane in to prevent the capillary break. Excellent idea. As you say, a lot of builders use pressure treated wood, but this, along with this type of wood, the standard type of 2x is an excellent option to go with. So good job. It's really good.
Gary, when we were walking the site, you kind of noticed one kind of interesting aspect of ICF that builders often ask you about, this idea of a corner. How do we optimize the corner? Could you just speak to that a little bit?
Sure, Gord. One of the things with ICF is that people, just like you can with regular construction, you can cut the block. But when you do cut the block, in this case here, it is not going to be a perfect fit. So you will have to cut the block. But it is very important that when you're cutting a block, that you want to make sure that your webs are all going to line up.
Because, so that eight inch space.
Exactly. Yeah, because this is going to be where your drywaller is going to be attaching the drywall to.
Right.
Very important. What happens sometimes when that is the case is that you're cutting and then all of a sudden your blocks aren't aligning up properly. So you're going to have a standing seam. Standing seam is not a problem. And by standing seam is from the bottom right up to the top, it's going to be cut in the same place. That allows the web to be in the same place. It allows the block to be set the way it needs to be for continuous construction.
I guess there's something to be said for the architect knowing, as we mentioned before, the architect or the designer knowing the size of the block, particular blocks, and Amvics or others, so that they can kind of, we call it ICF, the plan?
100%. If you know the size of the material that you're going to be using, then conceivably you're going to be able to at least put this within a couple of inches of where it is now, and you may not have to have the standing seam. So having the architect and the engineers make sure that they understand the product before they design the building makes a lot of difference when it comes to construction.
Well, thanks for joining us today on the first of the site tours of the cottage that we're so pleased to be building for the family. This is one of the first of four video series that'll be coming to you. In future videos, we'll have a chance to look at the lepage windows going in. Then we'll have a look at the installation details for those windows. We'll talk about the siding installation. Really pleased to be able to show you the mechanical systems that are going to go into this NetZero. And then finally, we'll get a chance to experience what this is really going to look like in the summertime when you have that great view, as you can see, of the lake. And I'm gonna say to you, June 21st, the sun sets right out there, and it's really phenomenal. And to follow the project, just drop into buildingknowledge.ca or constructioninstruction.com.